Dear students, so today we'll learn organic chemistry in which we'll deal with name reactions. So number one I have chosen here is Frank-Wellsten reaction. So it's basically a halogen exchange reaction in which alkyl halides, alkyl chloride or bromide is replaced with iodide. So we can take the general example is, suppose if we have RX, so R is alkyl, X is halogen. Halogen could be your either chloride or bromide. Okay, in the presence of sodium iodide, our product will be RI plus NaX. So what we see here is the exchange of halogen. So X is a halogen, which is chloride or bromide. It's exchanged by iodine here. So if we take a particular example, CH3Br plus NaI, remember it requires a reaction medium, it should be your dry acetone. Okay, so dry acetone. So your product will be CH3I plus NaBr. Right, so what we see here is the exchange of, so iodine is bromine is exchanged by iodine. So this is basically the halogen exchange reaction. Another example we can take is CH3 is CH2 is CH, here is suppose Cl CH3. When it is treated with sodium iodide in the presence of dry acetone, okay, see, this chlorine is replaced by iodine. So your product becomes CH3CH2CH. Here comes ICH3. Yes. So you can see the chlorine is replaced by iodine in the product. So side product will be also be there. So it's NaCl. NaCl. Next halogen exchange reaction is Schwartz reaction, in which same alkyl halide, okay, so again its halogen could be either chloride or bromide. When it is treated with AgF, okay, and heat is required, so in this case this halogen is exchanged with fluoride. So what we get is RF, okay, plus AgX. Instead of AgX, F, we can use another material also. Instead of HGF, other reagents can be used like Hg2F2, COF2 or SbF3. The same, in this case, this halogen, chloride or bromide is exchanged with fluoride. We can take another example, proper example. Suppose if we have CS3, CH2, Cl, when it is treated with AgF and it's heated, what we get is this chlorine is replaced by fluorine. So what we get is a CH3CH2F as a major product plus AgCl. Alright, so another example I can take. Example number one, example number two. Suppose it could be anything, CS3, suppose Br. When it is treated with, I'll take another example, is COF2. When it is treated, again what we get is a CS3F as a major product. Okay, plus there will be side product like COBr2. So for that, balancing is required, right? Okay, so in the Schwartz reaction, so this is also the halogen exchange reaction in which this halogen, chloride or bromide, is exchanged by fluoride. Next reaction we'll talk about is the Hurth reaction. So in which alkyl halide, for example RX, so X could be again it's either chloride or bromide. When treated it with sodium, okay, it forms hydrocarbon, RR plus NaX, right? So we need here 2, 2, 2. So this alkyl halide, when reacts with sodium in the presence of dry ether, remember this is the reaction medium, we should have dry ether, then hydrocarbon is formed. Particular example I can take is, suppose if we have CH3Br plus 2Na, so here 2, so dry ether, then our product becomes CH3 plus 2NaBr. Okay, so how to do these reactions? Normally you have to follow a procedure, that is, you have to write here CH3Br, then just remove this one, then just join these two lines. Okay, join these two bond. So what you get is a CH3 bond CH3. So in this way, you get the product. So once you get the product, you have to omit this one. Okay, for example, I'll take another example. Suppose if we have CH3, here is suppose Cl, and when it reacts with sodium in the presence of dry ether. Okay, question normally. So you have to write the product. So that time you have to see when there is a sodium and dry ether, you have to think this is a which reaction. So what you do is you take pencil and just make the another molecule here. CH3, CH, CH3, Cl. Okay? Then we have chlorine skincha, we have chlorine skincha. And remember, now this is two molecules. One molecule this, one molecule this. Fine? Then you just join this. Jamra chlorine escape, yamra chlorine is here, the line, jodna pade. Okay? Jodha. Then you start writing from here. So it's a CH3. It's a CH. Your CH3, so your CH3 la talapati like you. CH3. How are you bond by you? Your bond ko where by CH. So it's bond CH. The bond ma pocha, yada CH3, so that's CH3. So yada CH3 tala junda deo, yada CH3 tala junda deo. Plus 2NaCl. Okay, so in this way, you have to reach the product. So once you get the product, then you just cross check. You have to always count the carbon number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it has to be 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 number. Tiyo bhai 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 right huncha. Okay, the next reaction we have taken is the phytic reaction, right? It's same as the Wood reaction, but here we take is a aryl halide. For example, if we have this benzene, so it's a chlorobenzene, so it's an aryl halide. Remember, when aryl halides react with sodium in the presence of dry ether, okay, so again it also dimerizes. So two molecules gets combined. So our product will be biphenyl. Plus 2NaCl. So the same thing. Two molecules, right? Which ma jasto pakarle gareko thiyo hamile. Same, yani Cl cha. Now you remove and just join these two. So you get benzene ring, join with another benzene ring. So this is called biphenyl. So this is the phytic reaction. The next reaction we will talk about is the Sandler reaction. So here in the Sandler reaction, we have aniline, right? So benzene ring with NH2 is aniline. When this aniline is react with HX, it's a halogen acid plus NaNO2, sodium nitrite. It's not NO3, it's an NO2, sodium nitrite. And the temperature has to be maintained is 0 to 5 degree Celsius. Okay, so which is equivalent to 273 to 278 Kelvin, right? So when this is treated with this, so it forms a benzene diazonium salt. Benzene diazonium salt. So it's we write is N2 plus X minus. So this is our benzene diazonium salt. So when this benzene diazonium salt is treated with cuprous chloride, Cu2Cl2. Cuprous, okay, OUS, cuprous chloride. Cuprous means oxidation number 1 here. So cuprous chloride, so we obtain a chlorobenzene. So Cl, so if it is an X, if I write here is X2, then here will be X, so we call it halobenzene. So this is the general reaction. So if I take a specific reaction, so example, so starting product is always aniline, remember NH2. When it is treated with HCl plus NaNO2, okay, and temperature is very important, 0 to 5 degree Celsius. Okay, to obtain a maximum yield, we need this temperature. So normally we do the reaction in a ice bath. Okay, we have a mixture of this in one test tube and we have aniline in another test tube, and we'll dip this both the test tube in a ice bath. We'll keep it for some time, then we'll react this too. Okay, then our benzene diazonium salt. So here is, this is a benzene diazonium now chloride. N2 positive, Cl negative. Because we have used Cl here, so now it's a benzene diazonium chloride. So when it is treated with Cu2Cl2, then it forms a chlorobenzene. Cl. So it's a chlorobenzene. So this reaction is known as Sandler reaction. Now remember, sometimes instead of this, okay, we use another reagent which is the same NH2. Okay, so you do it a mix kar da ki niskincha bhanda kere CNA ra Cl niskincha ra HNO2. Sometimes question ma HNO2 ma tem leheko huncha 0 to 5 degree Celsius leheko huncha. So you have to understand that aniline cha and HNO2 leheko cha, yo leheko cha, that means हाम्रो प्रोडक्ट बेन्जिन डाइजोनियम सल्टै बनिन्छ. N2Cl मात्रै लेख्दा पनि हुन्छ. ओके, अगेन इफ यु वान्ट टु ह्याभ अ ब्रोमिन देन यु हेभ टु एड Cu2Br2, देन हाम्रो प्रोडक्ट बनिन्छ ब्रोमो बेन्जिन. सो द नेक्स्ट रिएक्सन इज Hochschild-Fittig रिएक्सन. So in Hochschild-Fittig reactions, we'll have a two type of reactant. One is from Hoch, that is alkyl halide, and from Fittig, it's aryl halide. So if I have Rx plus another is benzene with X, then we have a sodium here and dry ether, then our product will be R with benzene plus 2NaX. So here comes 2. So this is basically Hochschild-Fittig reaction. So in the Hochschild-Fittig reaction, we take alkyl halide, aryl halide, then sodium in the presence of dry ether, then it is a hydrocarbon is formed. But in hydrocarbon, one is alkyl group, another is aryl group. If I take a particular example, this is the one, CH3Br. Remember, X is either chloride or bromide. Remember, X is either Cl or Br. So when this is treated with aryl halide, Br, then in the presence of 2Ne and dry ether, what we get is a CH3 benzene ring plus 2NeBr. Okay, so what does that dry means? Dry means ether is a liquid, okay, but dry means without any moisture or water. So ether should be very much dry. That means ether is a liquid, but it should not have any presence of moisture. Okay? So that is dry ether. So this is basically Hood's Fittig reaction. Okay. The next reaction is Friedel-Crafts reaction. So Friedel-Crafts reaction is of two types. Number one is Friedel-Crafts alkylation, and number two is Friedel-Crafts acylation. So Friedel-Crafts, see, alkylation. So Friedel-Crafts alkylation, first we'll read it. So in Friedel-Crafts alkylation, we have benzene or its derivative. Benzene or its derivative. Derivative means this is a benzene, and if I put here CH3, now it becomes benzene derivative. Instead of Cl3, if we have Cl, then it is a benzene derivative, right? So benzene sa tesma agamiko bhayeko chha bhane, we call it benzene derivative. So when benzene derivative reacts, benzene or benzene derivative, its derivative reacts with alkyl halide, okay? And in the presence of anhydrous, ANH, anhydrous AlCl3, aluminium chloride. It's a Lewis acid, remember. Anhydrous means, again, it's without water or moisture. So what will happen is that this R group, alkyl group, gets attached to the benzene ring. So what we get is this R. Okay, so alkyl benzene is formed. If I take a particular example, example number one, if I take benzene plus, if I take methyl chloride, then anhydrous AlCl3. Now what will happen is that this CH3 alkyl group will attach to the benzene. So where will the case? Jahin pani pasnu sakcha. It's my problem chahiye, because all carbons are equivalent here. So CH3, okay, so methyl benzene, so it's basically called toluene. Okay, isko reaction mechanism here bhanche ke huncha bhandakhere, yo chlorine lai Cl negative jun chai cha yo cha here yo bond chutindakhere chai CH3 positive Cl negative bhayera chutincha, right? Ra yo Cl negative chai yo isle lancha, because this is the Lewis acid. Acid chai is electron deficient compound, so euta Cl lancha yaha, yeah, right? So it is CH4 carbocation. Your carbocation is going to be benzene attack. Attack is going to be compound. But it's my important point. When we talk about that is benzene derivative, you have to be very much careful. Okay, suppose Cl. Then what up? Your CH3 IO, Cl IO, anhydrous AlCl3 cha. To aba yo CH3 kaha jancha ta bhanne kura huncha. So duita position cha, this is ortho, yo duita ortho bhayo, yo meta bhayo, yo para bhayo. So duita chances jaga ma chances cha, that is this methyl group will go to either ortho bhaneko yo duita equivalent position, yela esto palta na same huncha ni ta hai. So it's a equivalent position. So, ki chai ortho position ma jancha, ki chai para position ma jancha. So, normally, duitai product hamile pauncha. सो यहाँ सीएल यानी आई सीएच थ्री यसलाई भन्छ हामी अर्थो प्रडक्ट र अर्को हुन्छ हाम्रोमा पारा प्रडक्ट सीएच सॉरी सीएल यर इज सीएच थ्री ल तर अलवेज रिमेम्बर दिस इज योर माइनर प्रडक्ट एन्ड दिस इज योर मेजर प्रडक्ट मेजर प्रडक्ट नै हुन्छ मेजर माइनर भने यो लगभग लगभग तिम्रो 20% हुन्छ भने यो तिम्रो हुन्छ 80% हुन्छ ओके सो किन यसको लागि बिन भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ अब हेर्नु पर्यो दिस क्लोराइड ग्रुप इज अर्थो पारा डाइरेक्टिङ ग्रुप ओके यो हामी बाल्नु पर्छ वाइ इट इज बिकज यसमा जुन चाहिँ इलेक्ट्रोन छ तिनवटा पेयर हुन्छ यो चाहिँ डिलोकलाइजेसन हुन्छ टुवर्ड्स द बेन्जिन रिङ डिलोकलाइजेसन हुँदाखेरि यहाँनिर नेगेटिभ हुन्छ यहाँ नेगेटिभ र यहाँ नेगेटिभ हुन्छ र यो मैले अघि भनिसकेँ दिस इज अ सिएच थ्री पोजिटिभ भएर एट्याक गर्छ है सो पोजिटिभ भएर एट्याक कहाँ गर्छ भन्दा कि यो अर्थो किन यहाँ नेगेटिभ भएको हुन्छ यहाँ नेगेटिभ भएको हुन्छ सो यहाँ दुईवटा अर्थ छ नि त है भन्दाखेरि अर्थ प्रडक्ट बेसी हुनुपर्ने किन दुई जग्गा छ है तर अर्थ माइनरमा हुन्छ किन भन्दाखेरि ड्यु टु स्टेटिक हेन्ड्रेन्स स्टेटिक हेन्ड्रेन्स भनेको चाहिँ सिन्स यो कार्बन भयो जति पनि भयो हाइड्रोजन छ यिनीहरूमा एक एकवटा यो र यो क्लोरिन एउटै प्लेनमा हुन्छ एउटै प्लेनमा हुँदाखेरि यो सिएच थ्री पनि आउँदाखेरि सेम प्लेनमा आउनुपर्छ आउँदाखेरि चाहिँ यो ठोकिन्छ ओके सिएल सिएच सिएल इज बिगर ग्रुप कार्बनभन्दा ठुलो ग्रुप हो नि त होइन सो सिएच थ्री इज अल एगेन बिगर ग्रुप किन सीमा तिनवटा आँगा छ है सिएचएच थ्रीको सो त्यसले गर्दाखेरि यहाँनिर ठोकिन्छ सो यहाँनिर स्टेरिक हेन्ड्रेन्स गर्दाखेरि यो एङ बोन्डमा के हुन्छ स्ट्रेन डेभलप भइरहेको हुन्छ स्ट्रेन डेभलप हुँदाखेरि चाहिँ यो सिएच थ्री यहाँ चाहिँ त्यति जानु मान्दैन किन यहाँ जाँदाखेरि पुरा यहाँनिर दुईजना बिचमा ठोकिन्छ टेन्सन हुन्छ ओके त्यसलाई भन्छ हामी स्टेरिक हेन्ड्रेन्स सो ड्यु टु द्याट स्टेरिक हेन्ड्रेन्स यहाँ जानु मन पराउँदैन सो इट विल गो टु द पारा प्रडक्ट किन पारा जाँदा यो टाढोमा भयो नि त होइन सो पारा प्रडक्ट विल बी द मेजर प्रडक्ट यहाँ जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ ओके सो द्याट इज द बेसिक सो एउटा यो कुरा चाहिँ इम्पोर्टेन्ट याद गर्नु पऱ्यो सो यहाँ कुन चाहिँ ग्रुप छ इलेक्ट्रोन रिलिजिङ ग्रुप छ भने चाहिँ अलग याद गर्नु पारा प्रडक्ट विल बी द मेजर प्रडक्ट वान मोर एक्जाम्पल वी क्यान टेक हियर CH3 अलरेडी एउटा ग्रुप छ है देन वी हेभ सपोज CH3 CH2 यो त कुनै पनि हुनसक्छ एल्काइल हेलाइड देन एनहाइड्रस ANHY एनहाइड्रस ALCl3 एनहाइड्रस ALCl3 हुँदाखेरि के हुन्छ त न यो ग्रुप चाहिँ गएर एट्याक गर्छ कहाँनिर एज अ दिस वान सो अघि पनि भनिसके अगेन दिस मिथाइल ग्रुप इज अल्सो अर्थो पाराडाइरेक्टिङ ग्रुप मिथाइल ग्रुप इज अल्सो अर्थो पारा डाइरेक्टिङ ग्रुप त्यसले गर्दा कि चाहिँ प्रडक्ट यहाँ जान्छ कि यहाँ जान्छ पारा पोजिसनमा जान्छ एज अ मेजर प्रडक्ट बिकज यहाँ जाँदा स्टेरिक हेन्ड्रेन्स हुन्छ सो सिएच थ्री यहाँ भइगयो सो यहाँनिर सिएच टु सिएच थ्री ओके याद गर्नु है बोन्ड यहाँ ब्रेक हुन्छ यहाँ ब्रेक भएर यो सिई चाहिँ जोइन हुन्छ गर्दाखेरि सिएच टु पहिला आउँछ त्यसको बादमा सिएच थ्री ओके सो दिस इज योर माइनर product plus another product we get is a para product CH3 CH2 CH3 so this is your major product right exam ma euta matai answer likhne paryo bhane chai you always write the major product the next reaction we will do is a Friedel-Crafts acylation So here it's same as Friedel-Crafts alkylation, but the instead of alkyl halide we'll use acyl halide. So here we have a benzene or its derivative. When react with acyl halide, so this is your acyl chloride. Okay, acetyl chloride is specific name. In general, we call it acyl chloride. So in the presence of anhydrous ANHY anhydrous ALCl3 in the presence of anhydrous ALCl3 again this chlorine is lancha ra yo group le goera chai eta attack garcha okay so our product will be benzene ring with C double bond O CH3 that going to point of contact yaad garnu parcha yaha bond break huncha क्लोर कार्बन ले त लगिहाल्छ, यो क्लोरिन ले त यो नेगेटिभ लगिहाल्छ र यो जुन चाहिँ छ यसले गएर यता अट्याक गर्छ। ओके सो दिस इज योर फ्रिडल कप एसाइलेसन। यसमा पनि सेम कुरा याद गर्नुपर्छ, इफ देयर इज अ इलेक्ट्रोन विथड्रॉ रिलीजिंग ग्रुप छ, इलेक्ट्रोन रिलीजिंग ग्रुप जस्तै क्लोराइड ब्रोमाइड छ या आयोडाइड छ भने when this acyl chloride is there or acyl bromide whatever then anhydrous anhy anhydrous alcl3 त्यति बेला याद गर्नु पर्यो यहाँ बोन्ड टुटिन्छ यो क्लोरिन यता लान्छ सो यहाँ हुन्छ हाम्रो CH3C डबल बोन्ड हो पोजिटिभ भएको हुन्छ यसले चाहिँ गएर अर्थो र पारामा अट्याक गर्छ है त नर्मली इट विल गो टु द पारा प्रोडक्ट एज अ मेजर प्रोडक्ट सो दुईटै प्रडक्ट यहाँनिर लेख्दैछु फर यर रेफरेन्स बट वन्स यु राइट बोथ द प्रडक्ट यु अलवेज राइट दिस इज द माइनर माइनर प्रडक्ट ओके प्लस देन अनदर वन इज द मेजर प्रडक्ट थ्री सो हियर कम्स सी डबल बोन्ड ओ सी एच थ्री सो दिस इज आवर मेजर प्रडक्ट यो चाहिँ भयो हाम्रो फ्रिडल कप एसाइलेसन। यति नै डिफरेन्स छ, एसाइल ग्रुप हुन्छ यसमा अट्याक गर्ने ग्रुप चाहिँ वान अफ द रिएजेन्ट इज एसाइल ग्रुप।